that talk is great conference. Thanks,
organizer.
Okay, the title of my talk is Cuba Variety and Pasteurization Associated with a Joint Crystal for a Fine Type AN. This is joint work with Sachin Khan. In my talk, I'll talk about the explicit one-to-one correspondence between elusive component of Cuba variety and pasteurization associated with the southern topaz crystal called the joint crystal. So, the first part, I explain the realization of topaz crystal and a joint crystal. And second part, I explain the geometric realization of crystal. And last part, I explain the connection between the irreducible component of cuba variety and pasteurization of a joint crystal. Okay, first, in this talk, we focus on the type AN1. So I index that from 0 to n. And we define the affine pattern datums of AN1 type. As follows, this is the affine pattern matrix. Diagonal entries are 2, and off diagonal minus 1, and northeast and southwest entries are minus 1, and the other entries are 0. And P check is a dual weight lattice. And also P denotes a affine weight lattice. And here, lambda is a fundamental weight, and delta is a null root. And H is a Cartan subalgebra. And type check denotes a simple, the set of simple coroutes. We denote it by HI. And the set of alpha I denotes the set of simple roots. Note that alpha j of hi is aij. Aij is ij entries of Cartan matrix. Okay, then we need some more notation. Q denotes root lattice, and P plus denotes the set of dominant integral weight. And for any symbol Q, we define the Q integer as follows. And we can define the quantum affine algebra. Quantum affine algebra UQG is an algebra generated by EI tilde, EI, FI, and tilde, which is satisfying these conditions. Okay, first four conditions are called the violations, and remaining two conditions are called accelerations. Okay. Then in my talk, we'll talk about the two realizations of crystals. So we need the definition of crystal. Okay, here is the definition of abstract crystal. An abstract crystal associated with the algebra UQG is a set with a 5 mass weight with partial operator EI tilde and FI tilde, and epsilon I and phi I. Satisfying these conditions. Okay. The Cartan operator EI tilde and FI tilde increase the weight by alpha I or minus alpha I and increase the epsilon I or phi I by plus I or minus I. The most important condition is here, F condition. FI tilde B equals to B prime if and only B equals EI tilde B prime. So, partial operator EI tilde and FI tilde are inverse to each other. And also we can consider the morphism of crystals which commute with the Cartan operator. So crystals with a morphism form actually the category. So this category is called category of crystals. And this category has a natural tensor product. So this category actually becomes a tensor category. Okay. On the other hand, for any two elements B and B prime in the crystal B, we can draw the I-colored arrow. If FI tilde B is a B, B prime, then we draw the I-colored arrow from B to B prime. Then crystal has an I-colored graph structure. So from now on, we identify the crystal as a graph in this way. Okay, I give you two examples. This is a result by Kashiwara in 1991. And let lambda, lambda and b lambda be a crystal basis of irreducible integral by steric margin V of lambda. Then here lambda of, L of lambda is a crystal lattice, and b of lambda is a crystal basis. Then b of lambda is a UQG crystal. The same way, L of infinity and B of infinity be a crystal basis of UQG minus the B infinity also has a UQG crystal structure. Okay, then it is well known that there is a natural injection map from B lambda to the B infinity. So we denote this map by iota sub lambda. Okay, so now I give you a definition of path realization associated with the compact crystal. So we need a notion of a compact crystal. So with UQ prime G is the subalgebra of UQG generated by EI tilde and FI tilde. So the EI and FI and Q to the H. And these are classical notations. And let B be a crystal associated with the UQG prime. This crystal is called classical crystal. And define the epsilon of B and phi of B. B is the element in B, crystal B. Then we define the epsilon of B, the linear combination of lambda I, whose coefficient is epsilon I of B. Epsilon I and phi I is the map coming from the definition of a crystal. Then we define the perfect crystal of level L. Perfect crystal is the finite classical crystal B satisfying these conditions. So first condition is crystal B is the crystallograph of a finite dimensional UQG prime module. The second condition is B tends to be connected. And third one is there is some height weight of in B in some sense, in this sense. And next condition is the level of element B greater than or equal to the integer L. And the last one condition is the most important condition. For each lambda in this set, then there will exist a unique vector B sub lambda and B sub lambda in the crystal B, such that epsilon of B sub lambda is lambda and phi of B sub lambda is lambda. So this is the definition of the compact crystal of level L. But in the famous paper, Feynman scale, Kan, Kashiwara, Mizuno, Miwa, Nakashima, Nakayashiki in 1991, they proved that there is a crystal isomorphism between B lambda and B of epsilon of B lambda tensor B. Here is lambda is the dominant integral weight with level L, and B is the perfect crystal of level L. Then there is a crystal isomorphism which you have highest weight vector U lambda to U highest weight vector tensor B sub lambda. Okay. Then applying this theorem repeatedly, then we have a sequence of isomorphism, crystal isomorphism. I mean, applying the first, we get this isomorphism, and so on. Then we get the sequence of crystal isomorphism. Then eventually, the crystal B of lambda is embedded in the half infinite tensor product of perfect crystal B. So here is a notation B. Lambda sub 0 is lambda, and B0 is B naught is B the lambda, and so on. Then P sub lambda is a ground state path. We denote this ground state path. The sequence of B sub k, and P is called the lambda path in B. If Pk equals to Bk for all sufficient range k, then collect all lambda paths in B. We denote it by P triple B of lambda, which is called the path realization associated with perfect crystal B. Then, in the Feynman scale, 1991, they proved that there is a unique crystal isomorphism from the crystal B sub lambda to the path realizations. Which maps the highest weight vector to the ground state path. Okay, I give you two examples. This example, the particle D1 is given as follows in the graph. And ground state pass P sub lambda I, so the sequence of the BIs. Okay, look at this graph. This graph, this is the Pythagoras path. Then, I give you some remark. In following the arrows, and following the arrows, then the number appeared in the crystal is increasing. I mean, here is 1, and following the line, 2, and 3, and go on, and then first 1. So, in this perfect crystal, following the arrows, the number is increasing. That's the... yes. And the collector of all lambda I passing B is denoted by P1 of lambda 1. And here is another example. Perfect crystal EN and its ground state path P sub lambda N and IN are given as follows. And this is the perfect crystal. Actually, perfect crystal PM is a dual of the crystals P1 in the previous slide. Look at the number in the crystal following the arrow. The number is decreased, M plus 1, and so on, and 2, and 1. So the pattern of number is exactly the opposite. And PN of lambda I is the set of all lambda I passing BN. Okay, now we'll talk about the path realization of adjoint crystals. So I give you a definition of adjoint crystals. In 2006, Frankel, Kang, and Lee give a uniform construction of Lebesgue perfect crystals called adjoint crystals for all affine quantum algebra in a uniform way. UQG prime crystals. Adjoint crystal is the direction of a trivial crystal and the crystal of adjoint representations of finite dimensional simple Lie algebra, which is contained in the Cassini algebra. So adjoint crystal has all roots of finite dimensional simple Lie algebra. And this adjoint crystal is constructed in a uniform way for all of quantum affine algebra. So we believe that it has a nice property coming from the Cassini algebra, and its realization also reflects good property of representation for all quantum affine algebra. So for that reason, we studied this special perfect crystal. In my talk, we focus on the type AN1, so I give you a definition of type AN1. EF is the union of this set. It's a single element. We denote it by trivial crystals, and here is the B sub plus minus alpha ij, and HI is the index set 1 to N. Well, alpha ij is a linear combination of simple roots, so alpha I cross to the alpha j, which denotes this is the roots of finite simple algebra of type A, and the arrow is defined as follows. Then it becomes the perfect crystal of level 1. And ground state path is just a sequence of 0. Empty. Okay. Then also there is a natural crystal isomorphism from tensor product of Bn and B1 to the adjoint crystal given by this map. Observing this map, then actually this map is almost determined by the weight of Bij tensor Bi. That means the weight is non-zero. Then you get the element in the adjoint crystal given by the weight, and weight is zero, then the image of Bij bar tensor Bi is the Hi or the empty, and collect all lambda zero paths in adjoint crystal P order with lambda zero. Okay, so before closing the first part, I give another combinatorial realization by using the Collard-Young diagrams. The Collard-Young diagram realization will be used in the proof of our main theorem. So I give a definition of that. Many people study on the Kaladin diagram, but one of the important results is by Mizra and Miwa in 1999. They give an explicit description of B sub lambda I for affine type AN in terms of Kaladin diagram. And later, Kang in 2000 gave an explicit description of crystals of Bayesian representations for other types in terms of Yangwa. Yangwa is a generalization of Kaladin diagrams. Okay. Here I introduce two kinds of Yangwas. In this talk we follow the notation of Yangwas because although in this talk we talk about for AN type, but we will extend our results to other types, so we will follow the notation of Yangwas. Okay. I introduce two types of Yangwas. The Yangwas Y1 consists of colored blocks stacked on the pattern P1 by subtle blocks. And Yn consists of the colored block on the other pattern Pn in the same nodes. Then actually the shape of the Yangwas looks like a Young diagram here. But I note that the number in the pattern following this line, the number is increased 0, 1, 2, 3, and k plus 1, and n 0, 1, 2. And following this line, then number is decreased. So actually, this pattern corresponding to the perfect crystal B1, and this pattern corresponds to the perfect crystal BN. Okay, and Y1 of lambda k is the set of Yangwas Y1 which is m+1 reduced, and Yn is the same way, the set of Yn which is m+1 reduced. Then this has a crystal structure coming from the I signature rule. Then we have a natural crystal isomorphism. Actually, we have a natural crystal isomorphism from the Yangwas to the path realization associated to the perfect crystal B1, and here is Bn. We have a Yangwas, then look at the column. Then actually the height of each column corresponds to the element in the perfect crystal B1. And here is the same way. So we have a Yangwas, then separate the column, then each column corresponding to the element in the perfect crystal. Okay. Now I talk about the geometric realization of crystals. Okay. I is index vector to n, and h is the arrow. I go to j such that i minus j is plus minus 1. And take the orientations. Omega is a counterclockwise orientation, and omega bar is a clockwise orientation. Then the underlying graph is a thinking diagram of type AN1. Then look at the orientation, then following the arrow, the number is increased, 0, 1, 2, 3, and then plus 1, and following the arrow, the number is decreased. So actually, this orientation and this orientation correspond to the perfect crystal B1 and Bn. Okay, then we define the epsilon map, which gives us the sign of orientation as follows. Okay, then on I grade vector space V, we set a dimension vector of V. Dimension vector V is a linear summation of alpha I, whose coefficient is the dimension Vi. Each alpha in the root lattice, we define the I-graded vector space as follows. V of alpha is a direct sum of space Vi of alpha, where Vi of alpha is the vector space of dimension K. So for each alpha, we fix the vector space as follows, V of alpha. And the same way, So if she dominates integral lambda, we define the hybrid vector space as follows. And also, in the same way, for each dominant integral lambda, we fix the hybrid vector space W of lambda. Okay, for simplicity, we said V denotes V of alpha, W denotes W of lambda. Then, we can define the space E of alpha. E of alpha is the direct sum of two space, E sub omega of alpha, and E sub omega bar of alpha. E omega of alpha is the direct sum of half space, which is given by the orientation omega. And omega E omega bar of alpha is the direct sum of half space, given by the opposite orientation omega bar. In our case, it's A type, so E omega alpha is just the direct sum of half space from VI minus 1 to the VI. And this is the opposite way. Okay, then look at the pictures. E alpha is the direct sum of two space. E sub alpha of E sub omega of alpha and E sub omega bar of alpha. So we have a natural projection from here to here. We denote it by pi sub omega. And this map denotes pi. This map is pi sub omega bar. And take an element chi in this space. And then the image of chi under this map is denoted by S, and the image of chi under this map is denoted by X bar. So chi denotes the element in the space E of alpha, and X denotes the element in here, and X bar denotes the element in here. So When we usually f is chi is f plus x bar, that means f is sum of f and x bar, and f is element in here, and x bar is element in here. Okay. Then take a element chi in space E of alpha. Then in a suitable to the basis for V, we deal with a fine A type. So the matrix representation of F is of this form, and matrix representation of S bar is this form. Here is a block matrix x1 to the xn. Here is f0, and other blocks are all zero matrix. Okay. Here is the same way. So from now on, we consider the chi and x and S bar as a matrix of this form. Okay, so we can product to x and S bar and can add or get compute to the kernel of F. Okay, then and G of alpha is the product of automorphism of VI, which is a subgroup in this space, and in this group, automorphism V. Then G alpha acts on E alpha by the conjugate. And also we consider the non-degenerate G alpha invariant simplex form on E alpha, given as follows. Then actually E alpha can be viewed as a cotangent bundle of E omega alpha of alpha, E of E sub omega of alpha under this form. And our orientation is just the opposite. I mean, omega is counterclockwise, and omega bar is clockwise. So actually, E can be viewed as a cotangent bundle of another space, the other space, E sub omega bar of alpha. So because our orientation is symmetric. And also we can define the momentum map as follows. But in our case, it's A time, so moment map mu I of chi is just the difference of matrix. Xi, xi bar, minus xi plus 1 bar, and xi plus 1. Okay? And last definition is the nilpotent. Chi is a nilpotent if there is the number n such that the nth product of chi is zero. So if element satisfying these conditions, then F is called the nilpotent. Okay. Now finally we define the heuristic hyperbolicity. Okay. lambda of alpha, the superiority is the set of chi's in the space E of alpha, such that F is a chi is nilpotent and mu I of chi equal to zero for all i's. Then we consider the set of all reducible components and collect them. Then we denote it by B of infinity. So B of infinity, you know, is the union of irreducible components of elliptic variety. Note that F is an irreducible component of elliptic variety, then actually F is a closed-up Knorr bundle of a certain G alpha orbit in the space E sub omega of alpha. And our orientation is symmetric. I mean, omega is clockwise and omega by is counterclockwise. Omega is counterclockwise and omega is clockwise. So in the same way, X is a cloud of Knorr bundle on the southern G alpha orbit in the other space, E sub omega bar of alpha. Southern G alpha orbit means G alpha orbit satisfying for periodic conditions. So, okay. Then, in 1997, Kachar and Fenster gave a crystal structure on this set, B of infinity, and they proved that there is a unique crystal isomorphism between them. So we call it the geometric realization of crystals. Okay, we need a more definition to define the Nakajima variety. So that E of lambda and alpha is a product of two varieties. The first one is the elliptic variety, and the second one is the sum of the half space from Vi to the Wi. And then the group G of alpha is on this space by as follows. The first one is conjugate, and second one is just a multiplication. Complex number C. And for chi, for any element chi in this space, the I-grade subspace F is the chi-stable. That means the subspace, I-grade subspace is invariant under the chi. And now we define the definition of the stable point. The element chi and T is called the stable point if it satisfies following conditions. That means F is a chi-stable subspace with this property, then F is empty set. If the element satisfying these conditions, we call the element a stable point. And collect all stable points, and then consider the geometric quotient of the stable point by G of alpha. And this is the Lagrange subvariety of Nakajima pure variety. Okay. In this talk, we call it just the Nakajima pure variety. Then, in the same way, we collect all irreducible components of Nakajima pure variety, and we denote it by lambda of B of lambda. Then, 2002, Saito gave a crystal structure in this set and proved that there is a unique crystal isomorphism from the geometric relation B of lambda to the B of lambda. Okay. Then, note that there is a natural injection from the geometric realization B of lambda to the infinity because by Saito and Kachar Saito theorems, the geometric realization B lambda is equal to the B sub lambda, the crystal B of lambda, and geometric realization B infinity also isomorphic to the B and infinity. So from there, we have a natural injection from here to here. We denote it by the same notation, U sub lambda. Okay. Then I talk about the two realization, path realization, and the geometric realization. In the left part, we'll talk about the connection of them. Okay. In 2003, Franklin and Savage gave an enumeration of Nakajima variety in terms of the Young diagrams, colored Young diagrams, the type AN and the affine type AN. in the 2015, scientists proved that there is a crystallized mutation from the lambda to the young one for AN1 and DN1 explicitly by using the previous result. So, I mean, I give this result briefly, very briefly. And take a little component F in this set, Nakajima variety. So F is the irreducible component of the Nakajima variety. Then F can be written at this point. This expression for some F0. F0 is the elusive variety. Actually, F0 is the image of F under the disk injection, natural injection. So F is F times the disk space, intersection the stable point, and quotiented by the G of alpha. The important thing is that F is not empty. If and only this intersection is not empty, I mean, this is empty or not empty, we just look at this intersection. So, Franke and Sergi construct a special point in this set, chi-na, which is not killed by the stable condition. So, using this special point, they enumerate the Nakajima variety. It is the chi is not killed by the stable conditions. We compute the Jordan canonical form of F not bar. F not bar is the image of chi not under the natural projection chi of omega bar. Then we have the Jordan canonical form. This is the Jordan block. The size of the lambda one is the size of Jordan block. Then we can construct the Young diagram. Here is the lambda 1, the length of low is lambda 1 and lambda 2 and so on. Then they prove that this Young diagram actually n reduced the Young diagram. Oh, also we deal with the vector space, I grade vector space, so this colored Young diagram has I colored. So this is I colored Young diagram which shapes the n plus 1 reduced. So using this process, Franken and Sergi enumerate the whole Nakajima variety. And we record the map of the elliptic variety, X0. X0 is the closure of conformal bundle, of G alpha of it in the space E omega of alpha or E omega bar of alpha. So actually, this element, X0 bar, is contained in the G alpha of it. So our orientation is the opposite, I mean clockwise orientation, and omega bar is counterclockwise orientation and clockwise orientation. So using that set, we did the Franken and Sergi result. We get the following result. F is the irreducible component of Nakajima variety. And take a generic point chi in the space F0. F0 is the image of F under the natural injection. So F0 is an elliptic variety. Then F0 can be written as F plus F bar. Then here is F and compute the Jordan canonical form and construct the colored Young diagrams. And actually this N plus one is this colored Young diagram is an element in the set of Young one, Y1. And we have also know the natural isomorphism from the set of Young one to the past realizations associated with the protagonist of V1. And here is the same way. There is the exactly opposite way, F0, and compute the Jordan block, Jordan canonical form, and construct the and construct the Young diagram. Then this is element in the Young one y to the n of lambda k, and we have a natural isomorphism from here to the past realization of Pn. Look at this isomorphism. This isomorphism is consider the Young one, and for each column, that column, the height of this column corresponding to the element in the protagonist V1. So, then what is the column? Column is just the first column is just the number of blocks, number of Jordan blocks. That's the first column. The number of Jordan block is exactly the dimension of the kernel S. Dimension of kernel S. So this map is from the Nakajima variety to the path variation given by the kernel of this matrix. So here is the same way. So we have a following theorem. Here is a crystallized function from D of lambda k to the path realization associated to perfect crystal B1, and here is the Bn. Then x is the illustrative component of Nakajima variety. Then take a generic point chi is the x plus x bar in the image of x under the natural induction. So this yield plus of lambda of k is the illustrative variety. Then comes the kernel of x to the I and kernel of x bar to the I. Xi and xi bar, x and x bar is just a matrix. So we can compute the W kernel and also compute the dimension of kernel. Then that's the result. The path, the lambda path, is given as is the sequence, and each entry is BAJ, BAI, is given by the dimension of this space, WI plus 1 of WI. So we have, here is the same way. So we have an illustrative component of Nakajima variety. Then we find that the image of S under the natural induction. And then we get the illustrative component of illustrative variety. And take the generic point and compute the kernel and dimension of the kernel. Then we get the path realization in perfect crystal B1 and Bn. But our goal is adjoint crystals. So we need some observation. We call the crystal isomorphism this from the Bn tensor B1 to the adjoint crystals. So adjoint crystal is just the tensor product of two crystals. And we find from the fundamental theorem of perfect crystal, we have this crystal isomorphism B of some lambda 0 is isomorphic to the B of lambda 0 tensor B adjoint. So combining the previous theorem with this observation, then we get our main result. Here adjoint crystal isomorphism from the geometric realizations of B of lambda 0 to the path realization associated with adjoint crystals. And F is a useful component of B sub N, B sub lambda. And take a generic point chi in this space. This is the image of X under the natural injection. Then chi is the X plus X bar. Then consider the kernel of X times X bar to the K. X and X bar is just a matrix, as I mentioned. So we can compute the kernel of X times X bar, and also compute the dimension vector of this space. And CK is the dimension of kernel of this map. But actually WK and WK cross 1 is chi stable, so we can restrict X to this quotient space. So this is just a matrix, so we can compute here. Then the path realization, then the image of X under this map, that is the lambda 0 path. Then each entry PK are given by the just the dimension vectors LK. Here is the CL is a classical projection to the wave lattice to the classical wave lattice. So CL of theta k is non-zero. Then we can determine the B minus CL of theta k, and the weight is zero. Then PK is just empty or H sub k dk. So using this theorem, we can describe the path realization explicitly. Take a Nakajima variety and consider the image of S under the natural map, natural injection. Then this is a Lutic variety. And take the generic point and compute the kernel and dimension vector of kernels. Then we get the path realization. Okay. I give you an idea of proof. Okay, first, you can prove that the kernel of S and kernel of S bar and kernel of S times S bar are all chi stable, which is invariant under the chi. So we can restrict to our element chi or X or X bar to this space or quotient space. This is well defined. And if we give a geometric interpretation of fundamental theorem of perfect crystal in our case, psi k1 is a crystallized function from d of lambda k to the b of lambda k minus 1 times b1. Then x is equal to x prime times b sub a. And this is a geometric interpretation. F0 is the image of x under the natural induction. And take a generic point chi and compute the dimension vector of chi, dimension vector of kernel x. We denote it by beta. Then x prime, there is a unique elusive component x prime containing in this set. Note that here is alpha minus beta, such that these two properties. The first property means that psi chi 1 of x is x prime times b sub a. And the weight of b sub a is determined by the vector, dimension vector beta. And the second one is that chi, restriction chi to the quotient space V of alpha over kernel x. Then essentially this restriction, so this matrix is contained, this matrix is actually the element in this space, the image of x prime under the natural induction. So that means roughly speaking, we have a kernel x, we have x, then image of x is x prime times b a. Then take a generic point chi in this set, and compute the kernel of x. Then we get this data b of a, and restrict chi to the quotient space v of alpha over kernel x. Then we get the generic point of this space, this variety. So that's the interpretation of the fundamental theorem of the crystal. And this is the same way. But the only difference is that here is the PM. And then lastly, we prove the following lemma. Q is an element in the weight lattice. And there is an open subset U in the S now, such that for any two element chi and chi prime, the kernel of this space is isomorphic. That means dimension vector of the kernel, dimension vector of this space are exactly the same as the dimension vector of this system. So open set U in the space, here this is a useful component that's not. Then any element in the open set U, the kernel of the dimension vector kernel of F times F naught the case is the same. So on this open set, we apply the previous theorem, which three, then we get our main result. Okay? We have 5-4 minutes. So I give an example. The G is the type A31, and take an element. Take an element in the crystal, P of lambda 0. Then alpha is lambda 0 minus weight of B, so the linear combination of alpha naught plus alpha 3, 4 alpha 0 plus 4 alpha 1 plus 4 alpha 2 plus 3 alpha naught, alpha 3. Okay, then first we want to find the Nakajima variety and take a geometric point of that and then compute the dimension vector. So finally we will get the path realization. So first we find the Nakajima variety correspond to this element. To do that, we consider the Young diagram. This B of lambda naught isomorphic to the Y, the set of young ones, YN. So using the Cassandra operator, we get the young diagram. We get the young ones, looks like this. So B is B corresponding to the young ones, my young. Then we find the matrix in the space E sub omega of alpha, whose Jordan blocks are given by this young diagram. Then actually we can find them. We can find the matrix X bar is in this space. Then each block matrix are given as follows. Then comes the Jordan block and comes the young diagram. Then the young diagram. Then we get this block. So we get F naught. Then consider the closure of conformal bundle of G alpha without F bar. That's exactly the irreducible component of the Nakajima and Lustig variety. F naught. Then what is the F naught? Actually, F naught is the image of B under this map. This is the isomorphism by Saito, and this is natural injection. So the F naught is actually the image of B under this map. So take the generic quantum here, F naught. Then actually this is suffice to take the generic quantum, the final F naught, because the F is the conformal bundle of G alpha of it. So it is sufficient to take a generic one in this fiber. The good thing is this fiber is computable. So we compute it. So then actually the fiber is itself such that this condition is actually this is coming from the momentum map conditions. So we compute the F. F is F of A1 to the A13. F of A1 to the A13 is given as follows. The matrix in this space, and the matrix is given as follows. And A is a complex number, and take a generic point. Then just to say that F is F of 1 to 1. Then we have F bar and F. Then we can compute the kernel of F, the kernel of X times X bar, and compute the dimension vector of Wi. Then finally we get the path realizations. That's the exact the image of B under this map. Okay. Thank you.
Is there any question?